And the last film that I'll be reviewing on this podcast is Mortal Engines, which stars Hira Hilmar, Robert Sheehan, and Hugo Weaving. And this movie takes place in a post-apocalyptic future where cities run on wheels. A young woman named Hester Shaw, played by Hilmar, sets out for revenge after the death of her mother at a young age, which has her targeting a man named Valentine, played by Weaving, who she feels is responsible. With vengeance on her mind, she teams up with an unlikely ally named Tom, played by Sheehan, to fulfill a much bigger purpose than what she intended on. And this movie, I really didn't know exactly what to think about it. It looked crazy. You got cities on wheels. So I'm just like, I'm about to go into this just expecting to like it. And just overall, I really did come out of here enjoying it. Some of the best things that this movie had to offer was the CG. It looked incredible. And at $100 million budget, yeah, you better expect it to look crazy good. And just the imagery and everything else was looking super, super good. Like, the CG was one of the shiny stars out of the whole film. Like, it really was the one thing that truly stand out amongst anything else. And it had some good ideas, it had some good concepts and everything else from what it was trying to do. And I really kind of felt I fell along with it. So that was one of the things that I did that did come into my favor. And the action fight scenes was done pretty well. I mean, I did like them. Like I said, the CG with the cities and all that stuff on wheels, and even just the regular hand-to-hand combat shooting fight scenes, I really did enjoy. And some of the worst things about this was the characters were really bad at like playing stuff low key. It was like they acted suspicious whenever they were, you know, not supposed to be doing something, or just, you know, a bad guy was supposed to be a bad guy, but, you know, they was trying to keep it low key. It was just, they just act overly suspicious to where it was like, yeah, you're not playing this subtle. You're really not. And that's going to bring me to another character. So before I get into that, the side quest. They have a side quest in here that just was kind of like, they could have did without. Some of the side characters was just there. They really added nothing more to the story, and the side quest was just that, just something just to make the runtime just kind of filler for the movie to exist in a I believe it was like a 2-something hour type, you know, deal, but it just didn't work. Just speaking of the characters that are suspicious, the villain Hugo Weaving as Valentine, it was certain scenes where he was supposed to act just subtle as, you know, I'm not the villain, just a kind of like a misdirect, and he just didn't. And I'm just like, really? So you're just gonna be the bad guy? Like, just forget it. You're just gonna be the bad guy? Like, forget the subtlety. I'm the bad guy, and that's it. It was just kind of like laughable. And the story was okay to me. Like, I didn't hate it like everyone else, but I could see where it didn't work. Some of the things that could have helped it better was the world building. It really didn't have no world building. It really didn't make any sense to like how, I mean, it explains how it got to the way it was, but just the cities on wheels, like it was a kind of a different concept, but at the same time, it was weird. How did it get to that point? It really didn't explain it too much to where it was like, I was just kind of confused. Like, okay, yeah, these look cool, but how did the idea come by putting cities on wheels, like, you know, and just stuff like that. But overall, this movie it has some enjoyment out of it. It's a very high budget B movie with a lot of problems, but I found some enjoyment out of it, and it was entertaining to me, visually stunning, really good to look at, but it just kind of failed as a movie, I guess you could say, or a good movie. I'll give it a 6. It wasn't horrible. I still enjoyed it, but hey, I mean, that's just me.